ke.
Yeah,
easy.
The
200
packets.
The 30.
Yeah.
Ngifuna laphekiwe, ngifuna utesta laphekiwe. Uzowapheka? Mo waphekile ngicela ukwa tester.
Okay.
No. It's so crunchy.
Masonja worms are like a South African delicacy. Well, like in certain tribes, not in my tribe. But they really have a bad rep because they're not that bad. Really great source of protein. Maybe the texture might get to you at first, but if you think of it as like crawfish, it's not that bad.
I realized that in my last video, I didn't do a proper intro. So if you're a new subscriber, hi sweetie, welcome to the good side with good content.
Or what?
If you're day one, you know, just grab your popcorn and enjoy this video. Work started pretty early today. I had a tour first thing when I got here. So I just finished the tour now and made my morning ramen. I just wanted to start off this vlog and just encourage you guys to keep on commenting, liking, subscribing. I really appreciate the love you guys have been giving my channel this year. I feel like we're also consistent with it. Still haven't shown you guys my new place.
It's cool sometimes.
It's so easy for me to overcloud all the good that has happened to me because of something momentarily negative, you know. I don't want to ever make the people who got me to where I am today to feel inadequate, but I do believe that it is time for me to spread my wings. It is time for me to go out there and just see for myself. Really hoping that this new stage in my life is gonna bring a lot of eye-opening energy, and I just really hope this stage of my life is going to make me see life for what it is. For the longest time, I just believed that everything was just gonna work out for me. Like, now that I'm like in it and I'm 22 and everything is not working out, it's kind of weird. Acceptance as well. Okay, I'm done venting.
Hey guys, I just knocked off of work and I'm going to see my friend Ria. Oh my gosh guys, I haven't seen him since I think like COVID.
Yeah, let's go.
It's actually crazy, whenever people come and see me or they come to my place, they see that you have to like enter a gravel road, then they always think I'm taking them to the deepest depths of the forest or something. Oh my gosh, Ria just called me and he was just like, where do you live? There's my friend.
Bruh.
Yes, ma'am.
Jerry Springer died at 79.
What?
Yeah.
When?
No.
Seriously? What happened?
I don't know.
At
79.
Damn.
Right?
Like, you just found out now?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
He was very entertaining, though.
Hey guys, today is Friday. I'm shooting this at the end of the month solely to reflect on what has happened. Well, you guys have seen the vlog, so I introduced the vlog, but I didn't speak much through it. Honestly, this month has taught me so much. Living alone is so different in every sense. There was like a wasp in here, and I've grown a fear to wasps because when I was moving in, actually, there was like a hornet's nest on my window, and I got stung by a hornet. So I feel like I have PTSD. Thinking of giving you guys like a proper room tour, but because my room is so incomplete, I don't want to do that. There's so many things I still want to do in terms of decoration and just making it feel more homey. Currently, I live in this bedsitter setup type of apartment. It's really, really small, built for one person. The peace of mind I have living alone is priceless. My mental wouldn't be this stable if I was still at home. I feel like that's what makes it worth it, even though at first when I was moving in, I was really bummed out because I was like, oh, it's
such a small space. I'm not used to being by myself. If I don't like it, inconveniences like here and there.
Once I got in and I spent the first few nights, I realized that it really wasn't that bad. I just wanted to be bougie, but you haven't bought half the stuff that you want in your room, so you know. I insert a few clips of what my room looks like. When you walk into my room before opening the door, there's a grass mat that I put outside just so I can clean my shoes before I go in. And immediately, that's my kitchen area. Keep all my groceries there. I try to do groceries weekly so I'm not overwhelmed with the stuff I have. This side is my window. I have two windows. When we go over to my bed, mattress is currently on the floor. There is a blanket that I put under it just to protect it from dirt or anything. I ordered bed pallets recently, so they're gonna arrive soon. On my wall, there's my calendar. Here is my vision board along with all my wall decorations, ivy wall thing going on. This compartment over here is where I keep all my cosmetics. And this side would be my suitcase and where I put all my clothes. I currently don't have a wardrobe or a closet set up. I want to get a mobile one soon, but I'll see how that goes. My dustbin as well as my things to clean. And that's it. Really not anything to rave about, but that space is my heart. I'm going to be spending most of this year here, so I might as well make it look roomy. Beggars can't be choosers in certain situations. It's a startup. I'm only 22 and having to move out at that age is really, really hard. I was talking to my friend the other day. For me, I can't grow in the same space where I was hurt. That childhood trauma along with the teenage trauma, my parents' house wasn't helping in me healing. It's so easy to ignore your demons. It's so easy to ignore your mental state when you're in your parents' house because you're always preoccupied. Now that I'm living alone, I have so much time to do that. Some days are darker than others. Appreciate them nonetheless. Just trying to be present. I saw this TikTok the other day. It was talking about how we need to appreciate where we currently are, because 20 years from now, we're going to miss being alone. We're going to miss having this bedsitter, going to miss being in this small space by yourself. As much as it's agonizing right now, you're gonna miss it. Really trying to enjoy where I am right now. Sorry for the noise outside. They're delivering like some artifacts or something. It's really rowdy. Trying a lot of new things in this video. Yeah, I go need a honey. I don't like it. It tastes like Drinko Pop and vitamin water made a baby. Powerade can do better than this. Hydration drink. There's a lot of sodium, but comment down below. I am going to see my friend after work. I am so excited, guys. Almost 2 months. Stay tuned to see that. Otherwise, I'm gonna close off this video. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. I'll talk to you guys on my next one. Right now, I'm gonna go read this book, Pulling Your Own Strings. I've been into reading mostly because stage 6 load shedding. I get bored and there's nothing to do for 4 hours. I like sitting here upstairs and basking in the sun. I read a chapter or two. This is actually my second book that I'm reading this year. I'm proud of myself. Oh my gosh, only first year me could see me. I'd be so proud. I've spoken enough, so let me go.
Two whole parties. Like, that's just being like
disgusting
in
way.
No, in Zulu it's like an enthusiende. You get what I mean? Like, no, like udlela emoneni.
Yeah. Oh, so you're saying
people that get double parties but udlela emoneni. Some kind of greed that I don't understand. Capitec is just,
it's the pain.
Yo, dude, the app just does other things sometimes. So sometimes it saves you from spending money, but most of the time it's annoying. It's not that one.
That's
not
mine. That one.
Ricochet.
I love it so much.
What's my favorite bass song on that album?
No, mine is Live For or Live. Like, yeah.
There's another one that's like a vibey, that's like a bop. Live For is a really good song. Feels like a warm blanket. I don't know.
I love that description.
Yeah. We transferred inside. It's not as great. It's definitely louder. Raining.